गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर विक्रम.
गुड इवनिंग.
दिस इज अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल इवनिंग एंड वी आर इन अ वेरी विलेज साइड एरिया.
वेरी वेरी नाइस वेदर.
सो माय कंसर्न इज रिलेटेड टू दिस ओनली. अर्लियर पीपल यूज टू लिव इन विलेज साइड्स एंड आई गॉट इट सर्च फ्रॉम यू ओनली. यू टोल्ड मी दैट पीपल अर्लियर वर नॉट वेरी मच प्रोन टू कैंसर. So, what are the causes of increased rate of cancer these days?
Yeah, you as you see, the incidence of cancer has increased manifold in the last 50 years or 100 years.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people are suffering from cancer nowadays. So, it is clear from this point that the cancer is increasing because of our lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
The new way of thinking, new way of living, new way of eating. So all these things have a lot of role to play in cancer incidence.
Okay.
Especially the x-rays and the exposure to radiation. It is also one of the leading cause.
Mm-hmm.
Use of pesticides and fertilizers in the crops.
Yeah.
Genetically modified foods.
Mm-hmm.
This is also one of the reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Medicines, a lot of drugs, people are using painkillers, indiscriminate use of drugs, medicine. Okay. So many type of antibiotics. Mm-hmm. And painkillers and so many other drugs, medicines.
Okay.
So people are using themselves and too many are responsible for the cancer. Even for digestive system, if you are having diarrhea, people, they consume metronidazole.
Yeah.
Nidazole, chloramphenicol, just for infections.
Mm-hmm.
So many patients, they come because of drug use. They
okay.
suffer from cancer. So these are the various reasons. Moreover, these radio waves now, the cell phones, the computers, and the,
yeah, and the EMF, Wi-Fi environments, all
transformers.
Uh-huh.
All these things, they have contributed increased incidence of cancer.
So this cancer, if someone suffers this,
yeah.
So what ultimately is the treatment? Like people go for radiotherapy, chemotherapy, but don't come to Ayurveda directly. Most of your patient I know.
Yeah.
So what you advise? Is it possible that they can use Ayurveda as a alternative or side by side with this radiotherapy, chemotherapy, like things?
Chemotherapy. Just imagine this wonderful field.
Okay.
Suppose these beautiful flowers are there.
Uh-huh.
And just put some chemical to destroy the crop.
Uh-huh.
And you will see some weeds are also growing there.
Yes.
Once you clear it with the chemical, the first thing to come up again will be the weeds, not the flowers.
Yeah.
So if you bombard your body with the chemicals, with radiation and chemotherapy,
mm-hmm.
and the cancer appears again. Not okay. the healthy cells.
Yeah, most of the people yeah. tell there is reoccurrence
cells,
also.
So there is a recurrence, chances of recurrence are too many with the chemotherapy and radiotherapy.
Okay.
I cannot claim that you don't go for chemotherapy, you don't go for radiotherapy.
Mm-hmm.
But if you ask me my personal viewpoint, if I suffer from cancer, I will not go for any chemotherapy. I would rather choose natural medicine.
Okay.
The natural herbs or the Ayurvedic medicines, because
okay.
nature has provided us so many so many things, roots, fruits, shoots, everything, grains,
okay.
which are rich in providing the strength and immunity to the body, to the cells, to
okay.
fight the cancer cells naturally.
Mm-hmm.
And if people they want to go for chemotherapy, I would still suggest them take some Ayurvedic herbs along with the chemotherapy.
Okay.
First of all, I would say don't go for chemotherapy, because chemotherapy is very dangerous.
Okay.
But if patient is young, if patient is can handle chemotherapy,
mm-hmm.
and it is indicated,
okay.
then I won't interfere.
Okay. But your suggestion is to use it side by side.
I cannot interfere.
Okay.
But if you ask me myself, I won't go for chemotherapy. Opt for chemotherapy.
That's great. So, Dr. Vikram, when someone comes to Ayurveda, so are there any herbs or medicines available for fighting cancer?
Yes, there are so many. There is curcumin. This curcumin is a wonderful herb from the turmeric.
Okay.
the active ingredient of turmeric.
Mm-hmm.
Curcumin is very popular nowadays. We have to modify the immune system of the patient.
Okay.
So amla is richest source of vitamin C. So I use curcumin, amla, ashwagandha, kachnar, mm-hmm. shatavari, gokshura, all these gugul, and so many kachnar, all these herbs to fight the cancer cells and also to replenish the system with the nutrients.
Okay.
I provide nutrition also,
mm-hmm.
like vitamin C, natural vitamin C. Vitamin C, amla is a small berry.
Yeah.
One berry is equal to 30 oranges.
Okay.
One small amla fruit. So I give amla fruit in abundance,
mm-hmm.
and other fruits and vegetables.
Okay.
Natural things.
Natural herbs you give. Herbs.
And some Ayurvedic medicines also there, which are very good for to fight cancers, various types
okay.
of cancers.
So Dr. Vikram, this treatment required for how long? For 6 months or a year or till the time cancer is taken care of properly?
In some cases, it needs 3 months, 6 months.
Okay.
In some cases, it may go up to 1 year.
Okay.
And in many cases, it can go up to beyond 1 year.
But there are no side effects for prolonged use?
No, there are no side effects. People can use it for years after years. The Ayurvedic herbs can be used.
Uh-huh. One question comes into my mind. These days, this soda bicarb is very popular over the YouTube. There are so many oncologists even claiming that it's very good. So what is Ayurvedic view on this soda bicarb?
Yeah, it's very interesting question you have asked. Soda bicarb has become very popular as a natural treatment of cancers.
Okay.
In Ayurveda, it is mentioned that it is a kshara.
Okay.
You can look for kshara in Ayurvedic.
Alkalizer?
Alkalizer.
Okay.
In Ayurvedic texts, which are written about 5,000 years ago, 2000 BC, 3000 BC,
and 1000 BC.
The kshara is the name of the alkalizers. Not only soda bicarb, but other kshara also can be used in cancers to fight the cancer cells. The cancer does not develop in an alkaline media.
Oh.
It develops only in the acidic media.
Oh.
When the body becomes acidic. For mm-hmm. example, if you change the media of the soil,
uh-huh.
Plants, they will not grow.
Yeah, it's true.
Similarly, cancer cell cannot grow in alkaline media. They grow only in acidic media.
Uh-huh.
So, use of alkaline things, alkaline materials, substances,
uh-huh. Uh-huh.
It is very much recommended in Ayurveda. It is called shara. There are pratisarniya shara and paniya shara. Paniya means which are given to drink orally.
Okay.
Pratisarniya is to apply locally.
Okay.
There are many pratisarniya shara,
mm-hmm.
which we use to cut off the tumors. We use threads. That
uh-huh.
is called Shar Sutra.
Uh-huh.
We use the Shar Sutra like we make some shara and put
okay.
some. Shara is alkalizer.
Uh-huh.
And
so make a thread out of
thread
that.
And we use like a thread to cut off the tumors and moles and warts and even the piles.
Oh.
And the fistula, healing of fistula.
Yeah, yeah.
So such things can be cured by using Shar Sutra.
So, that
is a thread. And internally we use Paniya Shara.
Okay.
So Paniya Shara is also good to alkalize the blood.
Okay.
So if you alkalize the blood, it should be monitored. It should not be too much alkalization because alkalization can be dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
For the system,
okay.
too much of alkalizer using.
So monitoring is
monitoring
very.
Monitoring is very important. It should be cycled, but it doesn't have any side effects. Mm-hmm. Too much of alkali use can cause so many problems.
Okay.
Electrolyte imbalances.
So under a proper doctor's
guidance
or observation. Okay.
If you use these shara,
uh-huh.
these we have a sajik shara,
mm-hmm.
soda bicarb, sodium bicarbonate, calcium, and other apamarg is another herb.
Okay.
We use potassium.
Okay.
Shara. So all these alkalizers of various types
that's
we use for treatment of cancer.
So this is basically not a very new search in Ayurveda. It was defined so many years back. Dr. Vikram, one more question. I'm taking too much of your time.
Okay.
Main question for all the cancer patients, the diet.
Yeah.
What type of foods they help the cancer patient basically?
Yeah, diet is very, very important in cancer patients. One should use purely natural diet.
Okay.
Natural diet, some fruits and vegetables which are red, green, yellow, all sort of beautiful fruits and flowers and vegetables should be used.
Okay.
I would recommend apples, if you ask me, one beautiful fruit for cancer.
Okay.
Apples is number one. Uh-huh. Berries, all sort of berries are good.
Okay.
Strawberries are good and amla is good, blueberries are good, all sort of berries are good.
Okay.
Melons, mango, watermelons, pears,
okay.
papaya,
mm-hmm.
beetroots,
okay.
pineapple, oh. all natural things.
Very colorful fruits.
Very colorful, whatever colorful is there. Uh-huh. I would recommend to fight the retinal degeneration, this plant called marigold flowers.
Okay, okay, okay.
It is very good for the retina. It contains zeaxanthin. And also this corn. Corn is a yellow fruit and corn should be taken for. So our wheatgrass is very good. Aloe vera is very good.
Okay.
Spirulina is very good.
That's
so
great.
All these nutrients. Ayurvedic chyawanprash is very good.
Oh, yeah,
so
jam,
all
herbal
the
jam.
Herbs which are rich in natural nutritive substances.
Okay.
They are very good for fighting the cancer.
So, thank you very much, Dr. Vikram, for sharing such a great information. I think viewers will be delighted and it will be helpful for them. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.